Thank you for being patient while we got everything taken care of and for being here today. If you can't hear me, just raise your hand. But my name is Jill Ayres. I work for Newport Orthopedic Institute. We work in collaboration with Hoag. I am a certified athletic trainer, which means if you've ever seen a sporting event, I'm the one who runs on the field to take care of athletes. But we do work in several different kinds of settings. I'm also the director of human performance and sports medicine over at Newport Orthopedic Institute. So I get my hands dirty in a lot of things. I also believe in participation. So if you have any questions as we go, you don't need to wait till the end. Just raise your hand and I'm quite happy to slow down or answer any questions as we go, okay? All right, so before we begin any type of mobility or any exercise of any kind, I want to set some kind of standards or some rules for you to follow, and this is with anything, not just with my class. First thing I want you to do is to know what your limits are. So I'm going to give you some exercises and some stretches and some things to do, but I don't want you to work through pain. I also don't want you to work through any injuries that you might be carrying with you. If you have something that bothers you, then stop. Then we can always talk after class about how to adjust it for you. Never hold your breath, okay? So that's really, really important for stretching. If you need help with alternatives or if you need a little bit extra guidance, go ahead and ask. I'm happy to help. And this goes for any program as well. If you take any other senior classes over here, either here or somewhere else, there's always an alternative. So if you're not comfortable with what we're suggesting for you, then you stop and ask for help. If you can't complete some of the exercises in the way we recommend them, then you can adjust it to more time-based. So for example, if I say, I want you to do this particular stretch and I want you to hold it for 10 seconds and you can do it for 2 or 3 seconds, then start there, okay? And as we go, if you want some advice on how to adjust things to make it more comfortable, then I'm happy to help again. So why is posture important? I mean, how many of you have shouted at your children, told them to sit up straight at the dinner table or told them to, because it looks better, right? I think I've done, I can't tell you how many times I've done that with my kid, but one of the main, this is some pretty decent research. I didn't want to bullet point it just because it is good information. So according to some of the research, maintaining good posture for seniors is vital, not only for when you exercise, but as you go throughout your day, okay? Poor posture, if it's not corrected by the right exercises, can lead to pain in many different areas, okay? That's referred to, or some people refer to it as postural pain syndrome. And what that means is that it can be changed, it can be corrected, okay? With the right stretches, with the right exercises for you, some of the pain, if it's caused by poor posture, it can change, which is a good thing. Certain muscles become weaker and shorter, and other muscles become longer and, some muscles become shorter and some muscles become weaker. So I'll show you a picture of what I mean by that. And over time, this can become something that becomes more permanent, but it can always change. So poor posture may lead to tightness in your chest and an overstretch of the muscles in your back, which is why you see some of this kind of a posture where your shoulders are rounded, which is very common, okay? Because everything in life is forward. If you think about it, right, we don't do a whole lot to encourage the muscles in our back to become stronger because everything is in front, okay? So we have to intentionally do different exercises to maintain a good position, okay? So even simple things as keeping your shoulders up and back and down throughout your day when you're doing dishes or picking up your grandkids or making your bed or whatever activities that may be normal everyday activities for you, it's a good idea just to practice getting into a position that's super easy. And that way you won't have to remember some of the more complicated things I am going to show you anyway. You can try doing these things throughout the day. If you feel like your shoulders are wandering forward, like if you are sitting and doing email or you just feel like you're starting to get a little tired, you can start just by changing that position, okay? Here's a picture of what I mean, okay? And forgive me, I do usually walk around. I'm trying not to, so I can stay within camera shot. So one of the things that happens, I'm sorry this picture isn't super clear, but you can see you get a little bit of weakness in certain areas. So in your lower back and up around your neck muscles, you start to get a little bit weaker there. And then all in direct opposition, you get a little bit tight up into your neck muscles and into your chest muscles. Okay, so as certain muscles get tight, it decreases your range of motion, and then other muscles get weak, okay? But if it is all muscular before it becomes chronic, again, we can change it, okay? All right, so one of the first, this particular slide I took from more of a stress management course, but I love this slide because everything that you want to do, you're gonna start with breathing. Whenever you're going to correct either your posture, whether you have pain or you have tightness or you don't, it's always better to start in a relaxed state where you have the most amount of focus, attention, and just a really good relaxed feeling before you start your exercises. So if all of you want to just kind of sit up just a little bit straight, what I'm going to have you do is put one hand onto your belly and one hand onto your chest without smacking my microphone around a little here. Am I okay there? And all I want you to do is I just want you to breathe in through your nose. Let your belly fill up with air and then breathe out through your nose. If you have a little bit of a stuffy nose, you can still do this through your mouth if you like to as well. Okay, so breathe in, allowing your belly to rise, and then breathe out. Okay. And what you want to do is make sure that you're breathing in, you feel your belly rise. And as you breathe out, you feel your belly get smaller, if that makes sense, okay? Again, this will help you to get into a nice, relaxed, calm place in order to start, okay? Perfect, now we're all ready. So one of the things that I want to make sure that I tell you before we do these stretches is if you feel that it's too, if you feel the stretch before you use your hand to give a little bit more pressure, then stop there, okay? If you've done things like this in the past and it hurts you, then we stop as soon as you can feel it, okay? Even though I have a picture of you using your hand to pull on your head, if you're not comfortable, then we're not going to do that, okay? So again, let's have everybody sit up nice and tall. I'm gonna take you through some stretches now, okay? I wanted to focus most of this session on things that you can do at home. I think that's going to help you more than just listening to me talk, even though I could do that for the entire hour too, okay? So now we all get to play together. Okay, so sit up nice and tall. And what I want you to do is keep your shoulders back, okay? Make sure your ear is level with your shoulder, and I just want you to tip your head to one side, okay? If that feels good and you can feel the pressure, then hold it there. If you wanna feel a little bit more, take your middle two fingers, place it right above your ear, right in the middle, so you're pulling right in the middle of your head, and give it just a little bit of a gentle pull, okay? Be careful not to lean your chin forward. Be careful not to pull in a position that's going to hurt you. Just a gentle stretch, and hold that for a good 10 seconds. Good? All okay there? Perfect. Now what we're gonna do is same thing on the other side. So nice and tall, chest nice and high, tip your head to the other side. If you feel that stretch, hold it there. If you want a little bit extra stretch, take your two middle fingers, level with the middle part of your ear on the top of your head if you're having some shoulder issues. Gentle, gentle, gentle pull, okay? Knowing where you want to feel the stretch is important. So you want to feel this right from your ear all the way down to the top of your shoulder, okay? Good. You probably feel really relaxed when you're done here today. I'll tell you what, when I was putting this, when they asked me to do something different than I'd done before, this particular program I feel pretty strongly about. Posture for me is huge. So I got really excited and had about 40 slides and decided we needed to scale that back and start with the things that make the biggest difference first, which I think is going to be stretching and then educating you on how to get into the best position, okay? The next one of the things that happens is if your shoulders are forward and your head is forward, but you're still looking up, you're going to get a lot of tension right in the back. Does anybody get headaches quite regularly? Yeah, it doesn't get fixed by water all the time or sleep, or there can be a lot of reason for headaches. Sometimes it's tension. This one you do have to be careful with as well. If your shoulder is comfortable, you can use your arm right behind your back. So if you put your right hand right into the small of your back, if you're not comfortable with your shoulder, then you don't need this part. Nice and tall. Now what you're going to do is you're going to take your chin and you're going to look towards your left hip, okay? And you're going to look straight down and then kind of roll your chin up towards the ceiling just a little bit. Where you want to feel it is right in the back of your neck. If you want to give it a little bit of a pull, so it's like you're listening to your left hip. So you're looking down and then roll your head just a tiny bit, okay? It's perfect. Excellent. Again, where you want to feel it is right from the back of your neck, along the back of your neck, down almost towards your shoulder blade a little bit, okay? So pretend you're listening to your hip, okay? If you can't remember that position, you're listening to your left hip. Same thing on the other side. Take your left hand right behind you, look straight down at your hip, at your right hip, and then just turn your ear a little bit towards your hip so you're giving it a listen, like your hip is saying something to you. Okay, and a little bit of a gentle pull with your right hand just to feel it in the back of your neck a little bit. If you feel it just like this without the overpressure, then that's fine too. Okay, everybody relax a little bit. Everybody okay so far? Okay, again, yes, sir.
Is there a question?
Sure, please. That's a good question. So the question in front here was that other presentations that they've been to before was encouraging them not to look down when they're reading and to suggest certain other positions that they can get to in reading if that's even. And I think the important thing is to change positions. Okay. So if you say, like, I enjoy reading, I'm not going to stop reading, I want to read, then maybe limit the amount of time that you read in one position. So if you're down here, because there is no one answer for every single person,
yeah,
right? Does that make sense?
Yeah.
So if you're in this position and you're looking down, you're reading, then I would limit it to, you know, 10, 20 minutes and then change position. Then maybe you can prop it somewhere. And then maybe you can change the chair that you're in, or you can, there's all kinds of things that you can get to put the book right in front of you.
All these ergonomic things.
There's lots of ergonomic things. You know, we can talk, I can help you search for the right tool that would work for both of you. But I think it is a good idea. It doesn't matter what you're doing. If you do it too much, you're bound to get an imbalance, right? So you're gonna get a tightness in one place and a weakness in another. So it is about recognizing that if you're doing something, so cross-stitching. Does anybody cross-stitch? My mother spends hours cross-stitching and sewing. And again, it's all down. It's fine motor skills, which is perfect and important for you to maintain your level of comfort and the things that you enjoy. But take a break, go for a little walk, do some of these stretches. I'm gonna show you some really easy stretches to do as well. These are just a few to get your neck going as well. This one is really important, okay? These are lovingly called chicken necks, or but they're actually technically called chin tucks or dorsal glides. So this one, believe it or not, is super, super important for you to maintain good posture. Again, as we said in the beginning, the first thing you wanna do is lift your chest up, your shoulders back and down. And in this position, because if you think about it, some of the things that you want to do is looking forward. If you get into this position, my nerves aren't working right, my muscles are being strained, and nothing's in a good position. So you really want to have your head up and your ear over your shoulder. And one of the ways that you can do that is by what's called a simple chin tuck. Now you can do these laying on your back as well, but I like them from when you're sitting because it gives you a reminder of what's supposed, where your head is supposed to be, sitting on top of your shoulders, which gives you the least amount of strain. So from here, what you're going to do, okay, sitting up nice and tall, you're gonna look straight forward, okay, and you're gonna tuck your chin straight backwards like it's on a slide, okay? So forgive me, I'm gonna walk over this way real quick. I'll be right back. So from here, making sure that you're on a slide, okay, so your chin, you're just gonna tuck it straight back, okay? And then relax. And again, just go to your level of comfort. Okay? If you do this and you start to get a headache straight away, back off a little bit. Okay? But these are fantastic. Has anybody ever been to a physical therapist for their neck? No? Nobody has? Oh, you have? Did they give you these exercises before? Okay. The wall walks and, oh yes, the standard, yeah, they're pretty standard. But this is a really good exercise for keeping everything in a good place, okay? And it allows everything to function normally. So just tuck your chin. So if you tuck your chin, you mess up that skin a little bit, you're doing it perfect, okay? And again, I would probably do just a couple of these at a time. Too many of them might give you a little bit of a headache, okay? This is another one of my favorite ones, okay? I call these waiter tips. Other people call them no monies, which I think is really negative. So we keep it as a waiter asking for a tip, right? At the end of their serve, if they said, I did a good job, give me a tip, right? So this one, you're gonna sit up nice and tall, your elbows locked in straight at your side. Now your chin is tucked. Now you know what that position looks like. Keep your elbows straight in. Put your hands right on top of each other. So start this way with your hands on top of each other. And you're gonna lock your elbows in at the side. So pretend there's a pin going through one elbow and all the way to the other, and you're just gonna open your hands like a waiter asking for a tip. This is great to prevent frozen shoulders. It's good for your posture because if you're getting rounded, a lot of the muscles that are tighter in the front of your body, so we have to loosen those off a little, okay? So you're just gonna hold them and then relax. Now, if you're having shoulder pain when you do that, that's why I put this other picture on so you can look like jazz hands instead. That was a really silly way of describing it, but. So you can put your hands wide like this as long as you're wanting to stretch the front of your chest, okay? Because it's all connected somehow. Whenever you have pain, we look at what's happening from here up. If you're having shoulder pain or neck pain, it's not just in your shoulder or just in your neck, it's from here up, okay? So from here, I love this one. I feel like this gives me a lot of stress relief. And then just hold it. See? And then your grandkids might come give you a hug because your arms are open. Okay. And then just relax there. Perfect. Everybody's okay with that one? Excellent. All right, this one is pretty easy too. Again, some of the easiest exercises are the best for you, okay? Oh, we're running short on time already. Is that just me? Oh no, we started at 1:30, didn't we? I was thinking an hour went really too quickly. These are called scapular squeezes, okay? Or basically it's just squeezing your shoulder blades. There's two ways. If you've got any shoulder or neck pain and you're not comfortable moving your arms too much, you can do this just with your shoulder blades, okay? So sitting up nice and tall like you are now, all I'm gonna have you do is squeeze your shoulder blades together. Pretend there's a pencil in the middle of your back and you wanna hold that pencil there. And all you're gonna do is squeeze it, okay? And then relax. If you can't feel that and you want to do a little bit bigger, then you can bring your elbows back towards each other and just squeeze your shoulder blades together in the back. The shoulder blades being those two bones right in the back of your shoulder. Yeah? And just hold it. Make sure you breathe it. Now the tendency is to want to hold your breath. When you're doing it, don't hold your breath. Okay? Make sure you're breathing gently. Okay? And then relax. Perfect. Everybody's going to be so relaxed when you get out of here. Okay, now this is my husband. I grabbed him on the way out today because I couldn't find any great pictures that I like, so I made him stand up against the wall, so forgive all the my son's chores in the background on that list. This one is what I like to call angels, okay? This one is a fantastic way. It's good for your shoulders, it's good for your chest, it's good for your breathing, it's fantastic, right? The position you start in here is you're gonna start just like this, okay? You're gonna draw your hands way up over your head. Then you're going to bring your arms out wide with your shoulders. You're going to draw your wings. Okay, bring them right back down. Draw the bottom of your wings and then right back to your starting position. Make sure you're breathing, okay? So again, you're going to breathe in. It's almost yoga, isn't it? And as you cut to the top, that's the hardest part. And then as you start to come down, you can breathe out. Perfect. I like these exercises that you can give a visual to, right? So if you think, before you get your copy of this program, if you remember the angels, that's a fantastic way. I think it just gives you that good representation of what you're supposed to do. So you're creating your wings. So you're coming up the middle, creating your wings on the outside. Good, and then right back down. Good, perfect. Now I'll tell him he's famous. All right, everybody's good? I know this is very heavy on the exercises, but there's so much that we can do to correct posture that I wanted you to feel what it was like to get in good position instead of just talking at you, okay? And this is actually going pretty quickly too, so we can talk about some more individual things. There's a couple more things that we can do as well, but this particular This is more for standing, okay? This is a good visual representation of what you need to, the positions that you need to get in to support you when you're in a standing position. So whether you're doing an activity standing, or whether you're exercising, or if you're just transitioning from one room to another, we need to be able to identify what a good neutral core position is. Anybody focused on the core before? You've heard people talk about the core, whether it's yoga or Pilates or anything else. We talk a lot about the core, don't we? The reason they call it the core is because where everything comes together. It's where your top of your body and your bottom of your body come together. So it's the core of where everything happens. Are you a baseball fan, or are you just like baseball hats?
Baseball.
You are a baseball fan. So generally, the only reason I'm asking these questions is because baseball pitchers actually get their power generation from their core, so from their backside. So you'll find that the best pitchers have a bigger glute. I don't even know how to say that in a polite way, but it's, yeah.
Yeah, like this here, because they're going to be pushing off to get their power from the,
yep,
from right around.
Yep, all the power comes from here. So it also means the root of all your evil comes from there if you're in a bad position. So as soon as you get into a good position, you're in a better, stronger, stable position to do anything else that you want to do, okay? And the way that you find it, if you'd like to stand, I'll walk you through this one. If you don't want to, you don't have to. So from here, you can see on the left-hand side, that's perfect posture, right? That's what we can all strive for. Everything's in line. His knees, his ankles, his hips, his shoulders, his head is all in one nice big line, right? Did anybody watch the gymnastics in the Olympics this summer? Okay, and what do they do after every single activity? They pose, right? They do this, and they arch their back, and you're like, oof, how do they get that mobility? Well, if you stay in that position with your back arched too much, you're going to end up getting a lot of pain down here, okay? And then you see, I have a tendency to get in this bad position too, the one that's on the right, when I'm washing dishes. So if I have a lot of dishes to do, I have a tendency to put my hips up against the sink, and then I lean forward, and then I wonder why I'm sore, you know? And then I wonder why the back of my legs get sore. So there's ways that this bad posture will affect how you feel just by doing normal everyday activities, okay? So from here, what you want to do is, you can do this either from sitting, you can do it standing, you can do it laying down. What you want to do is you want to find a position right in the middle. So I'm not going to tell you that you need to be at 25 degrees here and 20 degrees there. Your neutral might be different than mine, okay? So what you want to do is you want to tilt your hips forward, okay? And then you want to tilt them back. And then find a position in the middle of those two that's comfortable for you, okay? Now, the way that you hold that position, that's your neutral. It's not too far forward, and it's not too far backward, okay? Right in the middle. You're gonna make this noise, a T and an S together, so it sounds like tss. You can feel that if you put your hand right onto your belly and you make that noise, everybody's gonna sound like snakes in this room, okay? Make that noise, tss. You're now holding your neutral. And I would like you to challenge yourself and practice that position in anything else that you do from here, especially if you get pain or discomfort, whether it is you're going for a walk or you're going to another exercise class or doing the dishes, okay? Walking up and down stairs, if you think, ooh, that's a little sore, start by flattening your back, arching your back, find a position right in the middle, tss, make that noise, tss, hold that position while you move, okay? Does that make sense? Okay, I believe, you know, like I said, I whittled this whole program down a little bit just to make sure that we weren't gonna be here for 4 hours. And that's all I've got. That's all I wanted to start with, was giving you the basics of what a good position looks like, what a bad position looks like, and how you can identify and maintain those good positions throughout your normal everyday activities, okay? Again, there's 121 ways to make every single exercise harder or easier, depending on you and your needs. And this was a little bit quick, which is good for me, but good for me to know but I want to open it up to if anybody has any questions. Any specific questions? Yes, sir.
I have osteoporosis.
Okay. So the question was basically osteoporosis. So osteoposrosis is not a funny thing, but it's, the flexibility will help you to maintain what range you have, because you're doing phenomenal, right? You're still moving, you're still active, you're still sharp. I think that that's fantastic for you. Osteoporosis, you're not going to hurt yourself by doing these kinds of stretches. In fact, it's very much going to be better for you if you can do some things weight-bearing too, okay? Because it encourages your bony structure to get a little bit stronger. So for you, you've got to do what you feel comfortable with, but still keep moving. Because otherwise, like the whole title of this program was, if you move it or you lose it. You know, so we have to make sure that you're moving in the right way. And if you're doing something that's a little bit more complicated and it doesn't hurt you, keep doing it. So I think that's really the method behind that madness. Does that help you at all?
Well, yeah, that's one of the reasons I got.
Yeah, absolutely.
I could, you know, be more erect.
Right, and there's two things that we want to do throughout life, right? Is we want to make sure that we're breathing properly. Like I have a family member right now that's not well and has been bedridden for months now, and they're getting a lot of pain in their abdominal area, and it's because they're not moving at all. They haven't been able to get out of bed. And as soon as they can get them up and moving and everything can kind of relax a little bit, everything's going to improve. So my feeling is that you've done so well this long because you are moving. And whatever movement that is that makes sense for you, I think is important to maintain.
Well, you know, we play bocce ball.
Bocce ball. Yeah. Oh my goodness, they're very English, isn't it? Yeah.
So that helps.
Yeah, perfect. Bocce ball is that's not easy. Is there any other questions right now? Or if anybody has any individual questions that they want to talk about, if there's limitations from certain conditions, I'm happy to talk you through things that would make sense for you as well individually. Okay, perfect. Thank you all so much. I appreciate you coming.